That first piece was entitled Legend of the Eagles. It's by a gentleman by the name of David Schaefer. The next piece that we're going to play for you has probably been their most challenging piece. We've worked on it quite extensively. The students came here today. We had about an hour and a half rehearsal, dress rehearsal here at the auditorium so we could get a feel for it. And we worked on this piece for probably, I'd say, an hour and 10 minutes of that hour and a half that we were here. And they put a lot of time and effort into it. It's difficult because it's not loud and in your face kind of like that, but all exciting. The next piece that we're going to play is called A Gentle Spirit. It's very lyrical, it's very smooth and flowing, it's legato together. And it takes a lot of work to get that, let alone getting that out of a group of seventh graders, who at that point in time are like, I want to eat lunch, Mr. Brown, please let me go eat lunch. No, we're going to play. And we talked about it, we even sang a little bit. It was kind of fun. We clapped and really kind of tried to get the idea for this piece. But this next piece is entitled, Of Gentle Spirit. Superior, 2 excellent, 3 good, 4 fair, and 5 poor. And the students have been working really hard to get ready for this performance, and it's one of the biggest, I guess, arrival points for them, because it's all what they've worked for all year to get to this point. And kind of mentioning that and saying something about solo and ensemble, you should be very, very proud of these students, because I know I am. We went to solo and ensemble, it's been about 3 weeks ago. We entered 50 events, 49 actually, that we were there to perform. And out of the 49 events that were performed, we received, I believe, 26 superior ratings. Out of those, 17 excellence and 6 goods. These students just did an outstanding job. And I want to make sure that I include on that, it wasn't just the 7th graders, it was the 7th graders and the 8th graders. Be very proud of the students and the work they've done. As we did earlier with the 6th graders, the most improved and most outstanding from each of the different instrument families, we'll do that as well as with the 7th graders. Most improved woodwind. This was actually probably the easiest decision I have had to make all year on anything. This student has just blown me away with how hard they've actually worked to get to where they are. The student didn't join band until late November and took a solo to solo and ensemble during a superior reading, and has just impressed me time and time again with their ability. So without a question, the most improved woodwind for 7th grade this year goes to Mr. Cody Waldron. This one was a little bit tougher. 7th grade, most improved brass player. This person probably is one of the, I don't want to say quieter people in band, because that's not the truth. But they let their playing speak for them. And probably a lot of people might think it goes unrecognized, but I have noticed it time and time again this year. And just spending a lot more time around this individual throughout the course of the year, from the fall through, I've just been very impressed with them, and I think without a question, they're the most improved brass player in this ensemble. And this year, that award goes to Mr. Blake Carl. And watching this student grow from last year to this year has been, without a question, probably one of my more enjoyable moments, just because they're a fun-loving kid, and every percussion section has one of those kids that just puts a smile on your face and is a goofball at the same time, but then also knows when to be serious. This year's most improved 7th grade percussionist is Mr. Will Eschbaugh. Most outstanding woodwind for this year. Raise your hand if you're a woodwind. Yeah, this is not an easy decision. Just kind of want to throw that out there. And looking at the way they lead by example, as well as they perform, and all the things that they do, this person is just one that I feel is very deserving of this award. I'm very, very proud of them. I'm very pleased with all the work that they've put in and their continued commitment. This year's most outstanding woodwind for 7th grade is Miss Hannah Kroner. Most outstanding brass player. Okay, I'm going to throw this out there. This kid, and this will kind of give away pretty quickly. This kid is a 7th grader, probably went and did one of the craziest, most insane things that he could, and had the time of his life doing it. He went to this thing called Tuba Christmas. Now, if you've never been to Tuba Christmas, it's all baritones and tubas. That's all there is, playing Christmas music. And he came back to me and goes, okay, I need to know what these notes are because I've never seen notes this high in my life. And just watching him this year as well has just shown me that he is such an outstanding musician and did an excellent job at all the things that he does. Never usually have to question any of his musical ability, Mr. Kelvin Watson. You know, there's that thing that you hear, there's a first time for everything. Well, this past year I got to see the first time for this. I have never seen, in all the years that I've been doing solo with ensemble, which would have gone back to when I was in fifth grade, have ever seen an adjudicator, that is a judge, stand and give a student a standing ovation at the end of their performance. And having said that, it's just without question that this was not a hard decision for me at all. The most outstanding percussionist in seventh grade this year is Miss Katie Kitchen. Piece that we're going to play for you as a 7th grade band is called Kamehameha, the Great Warrior, and it's written based through Hawaii influence, so this is their final piece.